When you're editing, have you ever wanted to change the color of your background? Or how about
changing the color of an object on screen? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to do both. My name's Javier Mercedes. I like doing video tech tutorials and gear reviews on this channel. And if you're into that kind of thing, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Let's jump right into it.
The first way to do this technique of changing the background behind me is actually really simple to implement because of the way I'm shooting this. My skin tones and my shirt are nowhere near in the same color spectrum as the background, that teal color. And I'm gonna show you three ways on how to do this technique. And this first one is probably the simplest and easy way to do it. The next two, the second one's probably just as easy. And the third one will give you the most manipulation of the colors. I'll save that for last. It's my preferred way, but let's talk about the first way to do this. In changing the background, you would go to your effects panel and look for an effect called change to color. Click and drag that effect onto the clip that you want to manipulate. Then we're going to go to the effects control panel for that clip while it's highlighted and scroll down to the change to color effect. Then you're gonna hit the color dropper and click the color that you wanna change. Now, once you click that color, hopefully you see something change on your screen. And in order to change it to the color that you would want to change it to, just go to the little white box right next to 2, click that, and that will bring up your color spectrum. And you'll want to move the mouse over to the colored side of that big square. Don't put it in the white or black part, somewhere where there's color. And then you can use that rainbow looking rectangle to drag and find the color that you want to change it to. Say like purple or orange or a greener green than teal. Now what you'll notice is that with these parameters, you can't really change it to black or white or gray for that matter as well. And in order to do that in the settings, we're gonna have to switch it from hue to hue and lightness. Now if you were to go to that 2 section, click it again and move the mouse over to the white side, now I have a white background. But it kind of looks cheesy, and if you wanted to really finesse how the color is picking up on camera, you can always go underneath the tolerance part of the menu and switch your hue, lightness, and saturation. But for the most part, this is for really quick change to color situations. I don't really use this effect that much other than for something like this where it was shot in a way that makes it really easy to change the color of something. So for the second technique, we're gonna talk about the hue versus hue in your lumetri panel. For this specifically, let's talk about objects on screen, and I have a blue ball and the inside of my glasses is blue. And if I just wanna color one of these objects on screen using the hue versus hue, let's talk about masking this the easiest way in Premiere Pro while changing the color of it. So I'm gonna pause myself here talking on screen so I can show it to you in Premiere.
So with the clip highlighted, if you don't have this Lumetri color window up, you can go up to window, Lumetri color. Alternatively, you could reach it by hitting the color window up here, and that will bring this up. But we're gonna go down to curves. And the one that we wanna look at is hue versus hue. Take the eyedropper and find a color, and it's gonna tell you the color that you eyedropped, and then it will create 2 points on either side of it that kind of breach the spectrum of where you dropped your eyedropper. As I move the node up and down on the line right here, you can tell that the color of whatever you selected is going to be represented by wherever the node is on the line. If I go up here to green, it turns to green. If I go down here to red, it turns to red. And one thing I'm noticing is that around the ball, I still need to select some of this color. So just to get that into the spectrum, I'm gonna create another node on the line and bring that kind of into the spectrum at an angle. So it kind of tampers off all into the same color right here, this pink color. Now let's go over how to mask and isolate a specific object to color. And after that, I'm gonna show you my favorite way on how to change the color of an object in Premiere.
Oh, and before I forget, if you liked the video so far, could you leave me a like on the video? It really helps out the channel. All right.
Now, in order to change the color of just the ball right here and not my glasses, it's very simple to do this by creating a mask and tracking that mask to the ball. Since I do have a ball, it would probably be easiest to do an ellipse mask from my Lumetri color tool, but just for those of you that may not be using something that's a circle, I'm gonna use the pen tool. Click the pen tool right here underneath the Lumetri color where we did our hue versus hue and draw a mask that's pretty big around the ball. After you've completed that mask, we can now go over here to the mask path and track the ball throughout this whole clip that I have selected right here. I'm going to track it forward, and now it's going to keyframe the ball and track it automatically inside Premiere Pro. So if you notice, if I scroll right here, it's tracking the ball and my glasses stay blue while the ball stays pink. One thing that I need to point out is that I started halfway through the clip, so I need to track backwards as well. So I'm going to do that by tracking backwards right here. And as you can see, the ball stays pink while my glasses stay their original color.
So now that you've learned about change to color, hue versus hue, let's go ahead and talk about my preferred method of doing this, which is utilizing the HSL tab in the Lumetri panel to change and manipulate the colors. And I like this one the most because it gives you the most versatility when selecting colors.
Once you highlight the clip that you want to work on, it may look something like this. We're going to go down to HSL Secondary. And like before, we're going to use a color picker, but now we have these two available to us as well. It's to add more color to the spectrum and to subtract color from the spectrum. This is kind of the master color picker. I'm going to hit this, and in order to show you what you are actually picking, I'm going to go down here to this color gray and highlight it. This is the color that you did pick. But the best thing about utilizing HSL Secondary is that now I can go to this plus color picker, click and drag that color picker all around the ball so it selects every single type of green that's within the ball. And since I shot this in a place where there isn't any other green in the picture, we're only picking up the green from the ball in the frame. And right there, I accidentally hit my skin color. But the cool thing is I can go to the minus color picker, subtract out any of that color. So now I'm only selecting the green ball. In order to fine tune this, we can go below these color pickers and go to the hue, saturation, and lightness. To change the spectrum of colors that you are selecting, you can move the middle bar here and notice how that's going to move along the color spectrum. You have two other parameters that you can change. This top arrow, if you click and drag, is going to change how much of the spectrum that you are editing. And the bottom arrow acts as a fade. So this would be 100% throughout this whole spectrum right here, and then it will fade down to 0%. To give you a better idea, let me do it right here. Notice how it's kind of fading into the other colors. So you can slightly put in more colors towards the end of the spectrum by using this bottom arrow. Underneath the color gray right here, we have denoise and blur. You don't want to go too hard on these for this kind of effect because it will definitely make it look artificial if you do too much. I'm going to uncheck my gray to see what's going on. And in order to change the actual color of the ball itself, you can do it right here on the color wheel. Let's say I wanted to change it to blue, and there's blue. One thing I have noticed when changing the color of an object is if I stay close to that color in the color spectrum. So since this is green, if I stay close to green, it's more believable in terms of the color that I try and switch it to. So if I try and switch it here over to this yellow, it still looks acceptable to a point. But if I try and switch the color to pink, it definitely looks a little too artificial. It looks kind of blue right here and then pink on the outsides. Another way that you could try and help and make this look more real is to split this up. So right now we're just working with the midtones. If we hit this tri wheel right here, now we can start dealing with the highlights and shadows. If you want to brighten or darken your shadows, you can right here. But let's say I wanted to try and turn the thing pink. Notice how it's getting a little bit better in terms of looking pink. It's definitely better. The outsides look fake, but you're just gonna have to fool around with the settings to try and find something that works for you. There's a before, and here's an after. Pretty cool, right? If I hit playback on this, pretty good until I actually close up the ball in my hand. But for the couple of frames where I'm holding it in my hand, it's not bad. Now let's say I wanted to take this footage and turn the ball from pink back to green, but I only wanted the green to be visible and everything else be in black and white. In order to accomplish something like this, I'm going to go to where I cover up the ball and split the clip up by hitting Command K or Control K on Windows. And I'm gonna restore these back to normal. And since I already have the ball selected right here, if I turn on the color gray, all I have to do is invert my selection. And if I wanted to change everything else to black and white, all I would have to do is go down to my saturation and turn that down all the way. Now I'm going to deselect this whole color gray, and look at that. We have a nice green ball right there. One cool thing to do in between it is maybe go over here and I'm going to type in cross dissolve and bring a cross dissolve onto this. So as I flip the ball over, it'll do this. That's pretty cool, right? So there you go, three different ways that you can change the color of objects in your videos. If you like my teaching style, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And I love doing Premiere Pro tutorials, so there's probably another one on the screen right now for you to click if you want to learn more. And until next episode, I hope you're out there living a life of abundance.